I mean, they always say to do comedy, you have to be brave. And I think there's nothing more brave than poking fun at yourself, which is obviously something you've been enjoying doing in recent years. I mean, how do you feel about that? I mean, do you think it's changed the way people sort of perceive you, kind of doing things like, obviously, Life Too Short and the stuff with Ricky?
I would hope so, because, you know, I did Celebrity Big Brother, which wasn't my finest moment, and then Ricky rang. So I wouldn't have got that if he hadn't been watching Celebrity Big Brother. And then I got a chance to show I had a sense of humour about it. And, you know, to lampoon yourself is the... It's an art, because you can't be pompous or, you know, conceited about yourself. You have to have a sense of humour about who you are and be self-deprecating. And that, for me, is, you know, Larry David, Larry Sanders, all those shows are what it's genius, the way people will go on and just take the mickey out of themselves.
Was there anything that you were doing with Ricky or with Warwick that you felt self-conscious about initially, or were sort of a little bit reticent about kind of poking fun at?
Well, you know, when Ricky told me I was going to be playing a twisted, demented version of myself in Extras, and then he said, oh, by the way, as I was walking out the room, there's a naked scene. I went, what? He said, do you want an arse double? I said, no, we'll go with the real thing. So, you know, I remember thinking, oh, is that going to be okay? But, you know, What's funny is I said to Warwick tonight, I said, look, here you are sharing a dressing room with me. And he said, yeah, I'm going to tweet. I'm sharing a dressing room with Les. I'm getting a bit nervous in case he drops the towel. So, you know, to be able to poke fun at yourself and do it to the, you know, be brave with it, as you said, that's what, you know, good comedy's about.